So here we go. So, gonna wait for a few minutes. Oh, I actually started early. Well, according to my clock, anyway. So I decided to stream from YouTube because of the format that I chose. I'm gonna draw the illustration while monitoring your questions in chat. If someone will join me, of course. Vote ended in a rebel being a victor. And so the rebel is gonna be. I mean, the illustration. I already sketched something a couple of hours prior when I was setting up the streaming platform. It's actually the first time I stream, so it may be awkward, definitely, but I will try my best. Yeah, my main concern is that I see the questions. Setting up the mobile phone to check on the chat. So, a few words about this guy. A hard-working man on its path to righteous vengeance. Towards all that is Arcanian and evil, from his point of view, of course. Just quick check that everything is working. So I think it is. So I'm going to be I quite like this guy, so I'm gonna be finishing him for now. And then I was thinking to stream for an hour or more, maybe like hour and a half. And if it's gonna go well, maybe continue for 2 hours. Maybe I should set up some music. If it will be possible, of course. Ah, crap, I don't have enough devices to do that. So, yeah. Me in silence drawing. So, okay. Yeah, when I was thinking about this guy, I thought of the, you know, like a guy with a hard destiny in the world of Arcanian Empire. Like, of course, he's not a nobleman, let's say. So he's a simple working guy from the mines. And his life was tough. His early childhood friend died under the hooves of some nobleman's carriage. And maybe he died himself several times. Like once on a duel, or not on a duel even. Maybe he was killed by an Arcan just, you know, because an Arc wanted to kill him. To make a peasant suffer. And maybe the second time he died when he was working on the, somewhere in the mines nearby the Anizotti. And he was crushed by the stones. And so it's his last life. So he understands that all he's left in this world is just, you know, suffer a bit and then go to the shining pillar. But then an uprising starts, a rebellion of sorts. And he, oppressed all his life, decided to take up on arms his trusty pickaxe, yeah, and go bring some justice to this world. Рысян, ну-ка свали отсюда. My cat tries to help me with drawings. So. Maybe it's a bit early to for details, but can't help myself. So did you make all of that yourself? Yeah, I mean, doing it right now. Sorry for the delay with the question. I hope the translation is going. I have a feeling that it's stuck. No. Looks like everything's fine. So, yeah, I mean, just drawing. I made the sketch. Just a couple of hours ago, just before starting the stream. Yep. Well, some effort, of course, but we did so many illustrations for the game, so it's actually feels like, you know, going on the same rails, and doesn't feel so difficult. It's we all went with a pretty deep immersion of the setting. So what else want I tell you about this guy? Yeah, he came prepared, you know, the trusty pickaxe. Don't want to lose it. So he put sort of a leash around his arm. Do not leave it hanging in some Arkan's skull. Yeah. I have a feeling that people who do those things, I mean, streaming professionally, or, you know, make a living out of it, they probably have a few screens on their rig at the house. I don't, so it's kind of ridiculous, and I'm trying to not to miss any questions again. And hopefully I'm not missing anything. Sorry for the interruption. Yeah. But not so many viewers so far, but anyway. So, and the markings on his head, I actually thought that Arkans, well, probably like bastards, like Otton, they wouldn't actually kill the peasants when they have the last life. They would lash them, or, you know, make them suffer so much and injure them, actually, instead of killing them. Because, well, they know that this is the kind of last life, you know? So they cannot just die and be reborn without any injuries on them. Yeah, so I would thought that they would give them hell and just let them live. Not sure it will be the common practice, but the bastards like Otton definitely would do that. Dun, 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 dun. So I think if he's a commoner, he would wear like a super plain clothes. Something like rags. So he don't have any money for anything better. So he lives all his life wearing same clothes. Maybe a couple of sets of them. Made of something rough. Yeah, that was probably above it. Will he be carrying something in his hand or not? Not sure. Man, I doubt it's highly entertaining. You know, me silently just drawing out some stuff. Well, if you have any questions, if there are some people joining. No, nobody else joining, but well, anyway, if any questions, should try to answer them. Don't know much about the setting though. I mean, as much as any other person, but I haven't played all the playthroughs. I know the characters though, but I was trying to make the game is a surprise to myself as well, so haven't been delved deep into the complexities of the plot. Had a few playthroughs. What I've definitely learned is that I hate Sophia. Just hated her. The first playthrough, she completely messed everything up for me. The second, I was avoiding her. Nonetheless, she spoiled all the life of my Sir Brante. The second time as well. Yeah, let's add some music to the stream. The music is from the Void Brother. His tribute to lo-fi sounds. Yeah. So, what else is there for this guy? Yeah, he's carrying a satchel, not a purse. For the loot, obviously. Because what else people would do if the rebellion starts out in town? Loot some stuff. First, revenge. Second, loot. What's my favorite pass in the game and why? Okay, sorry for the delay with the question though. Thanks for asking. My favorite path. Well, I've tried going through the game like 3 times. And all 3 times, I ended up as a pathless. And suffered a utter defeat. But I would really like to play as a man of the clergy. The monk join the Inquisition. Do some stuff with Ulrich. But, well, what I guess what game about the life in general is that if you fail to go to the university, there might be some struggles ahead. Yeah. That definitely was my case. How many people were involved in making this game? I don't remember the complete number of people, but something around 10, I guess, maybe more. There were, I think, in some interview, it was made public that we had a few people who were working like contract based or in and out, you know, like making some of the content and then going doing something else. And I think it was like 8 or 10 people working like offline in the office doing stuff. One programmer, I think, like 3 or 4 game designers, maybe 5, I don't know, a couple of writers, and a few of those things were made, like they shared responsibilities, so people who wrote and made the game design decisions, they're probably the same people. I don't like this lag, man. So maybe he was a sailor. Or maybe not. What else would he have? Any suggestions, maybe? I'm kind of stuck with ideas of what else can we give the guy. What was my role in making the game? I was responsible for illustrations. Making the illustrations, dude. Yep, I work on freelance first, making just a few first illustrative pieces when they were thinking about the style of the game, how it's gonna look like. And then when they settled on the final look, I was moved to the office and worked in the office with the guys closely on the till the game was finished. And that was my part. Well, thanks, man. Glad you like it. I was trying to do my best. I'm glad the effort was received in a good way. Looks like he's wearing some traditional Russian peasant footwear, lapti. Which is, well, maybe not only Russian, maybe all peasants wear something ridiculous on their feet when they couldn't afford something decent. An eye patch. Yeah, why not? An eye patch. Maybe an eye patch. Oh, let's make it on a separate surface. That should be some ridiculous eye patch, like. Yeah, like if he has the eye patch on this eye, that one should look ominous and evil. Yeah, I think that would be appropriate. So like every Arkan knows that this guy doesn't come for the peace. Yeah, eye patch, not bad. What's my general opinion about the game, events, choices, endings, settings? Well, I really love the setting. In the beginning, it was a bit difficult to get my head around it. But the more it revealed, well, the setting about what happening in the world and what was happening in the world, and how it's all connected with each other. And in the beginning, the concept of like several deaths was a very new thing to me, and I was a bit struggling to accept it. But then the more you spend time learning the setting, the more you like it. You understand the plan of how it works together in some sort of synergy. The two gods that actually exist in the world of Sir Brante, which are like real. That's pretty cool. The choices and the whole gameplay, like following the path that closes one several opportunities but opens the other after you made your choice, that's quite cool. I since the beginning thought that it's a great idea, because in a way, if you simplify it, of course, that's basically how life works. Some things that you do here now today, it probably will form you as a person you are, and this person will not make different choices in the future because of who you are now. And the idea work this idea work greatly in the game, because it basically enforces this point of view. And said already that I wanted to be a monk and go for the religious path, but I never actually got to do it because I was interrupted, never got to the university, you know, kind of messed up with the wrong crowd, meaning Sophia. And she messed up the whole life of my Sir Brante. I like the time when the game is set, because it's sort of similar to European Renaissance, or a little bit later than that, in like 16th century, like a span of from 14th to 16th century of our history, like normal Earth history. And it sort of matches a little bit. And that's my favorite setting. Very dynamic and very visually stunning period in history of humanity. Well, at least European civilization is. And it's pretty cool that you have to play like around that times. Yeah, and I was trying to avoid death, you know, in my couple of playthroughs. I was like, in the first one, yeah, I did die, and I was set on a path of like a professional rebel. And on the second time when I played, I was aiming for the priest, and I ended up being a pathless. Which is basically the worst case scenario, because when you aim for something and you don't have the skills, you get in a situation where everything you do from that point on, from the university basically, when your life starts, like you're not able to pass any checks. And even if you continue to kind of like, you know, making an effort to become a professional rebel, but you're not, you're the guy who always wanted to be a priest, and just, you know, by the unlucky fate, you are with the pathless, and now you're printing the leaflets somewhere in Anisotti, and trying to create this, how do you call it, the net of spies and scheme, and you're not apted for it, and all you do is just fail and fail and fail, and you're like, okay, dude, I'm trying, but I'm just a priest who never became a priest. And it's terribly frustrating, because at some point you just see that you don't have enough anything, any skill to pass the check. Like at some point you have like nine, but I think it was will or religious knowledge or something like that, and to pass it you have to have like 10 or 11, and that was like a minimal check. And so the checks are getting higher with each further choice. And it's sad from the point of view of the player, of course. And I was like, oh, come on, man, again. But from the point of view of the role and of what happened to this guy, it's pretty cool to look at it. You know, from the side, like how someone struggles. And you know, not just out of how funny it is, but it's just strange and interesting story of someone else's life, which was quite fascinating. It didn't end well, of course. I think that priest died by the axe of some, of guys like this. Looters came to the house of Brante, and the middle son wasn't skilled enough to survive. Yeah, one skill point away, man. That's ridiculous. But it's amazing how the game gives you this, you know, the opportunity of having this multitude of experiences and basically, you know, the same setting. That's quite cool. But the frustration, dude, that's yeah. Yeah, but how do you usually play? Like, you play with open consequences? Because, well, there is an option, but I always thought that the game was meant to be played, and it's not like the opinion of the team, it's my personal opinion that for the genuine experience, you have to just dive into it. Just dive into the story and see where it will lead you. It's cool to strive for the ultimate best ending, or like finding all the endings of the game. But in my opinion, that's the freshness of the story and the freshness of the experience, which make this game shine, especially with the consequences that are closed for the reader, so you don't really know what's gonna happen. Actually, I think that the guys who designed the game they thought that I think Feller and Dima they had an interview before. I think they mentioned that the original way to play it is to see the consequences, like to see what's gonna happen and to make a conscious choice. Like, I know that that will happen and I'm making a decision to do it. Yeah, it's super hard when it's hidden, I know. And so yeah, back to the consequences thing. And so that was sort of their message, that you read, you kind of like you understand the situation, and then you make a choice with open consequences, of course. But well, like, everyone has its own preferences. For me, it's closed consequences. But to be honest, I picked a few times. Just like, oh, this is what's gonna happen. Yeah, I remembered a few moments because I was, like, frustrated to fail so many times in my in the scenes where I don't have enough skill for a skill check. Yeah, that's quite funny. Yeah, this guy's too thuggish looking for a miner. The guy who works in the mine, I mean. Well, anyway. Yeah, maybe you're right about this. Or at least, you know, like making a few like to get a different path just for the sake of learning what else the games has in store for me. Yeah, that's probably a wise decision, you know, to get some good stats for first couple of chapters and then continue exploring, maybe even with the close consequences. Yeah, good idea. How many times have you actually went through the game? If you mind me asking, of course. No, just all together. Oh, yep, like this. Wow, 12 times. That's great, man. Oh, right now you're playing. Cool. That's great. I'm glad you like the game, man. Or sorry, I mean, cannot decide which how to address you, because I'm not sure how to interpret your name. Yeah, me too. I actually think that game industry in general should, you know, strive for this direction. Making something heavy on choices and the story-driven narratives. And the scale, I think the scale of things is important as well, because here you start small as a child, but then you get involved in some greater things like revolutions, rebellions, you know, like some global events, which is great. And it doesn't what I really like about the plot of the game, I think it does it the switch from the childhood and like small problems towards the adult life and you know, the huge problems and global problems. It does this switch very naturally. Can you flow into this solving different problems? But I can think of some examples of plots where it just, you know, the scale changes as in such a pace which you're not prepared for it. But I think in this game you kind of like led into the new world very, very easy. The smooth transaction. Yeah, true. Times of turmoil of history of humanity. Yeah, it's an interesting base for development of a plot of a game. Definitely. Oh, thanks, dude. Glad you like it. Yeah, it looks pretty okay to me as well. I want to add more like darker areas to make it stand out a little bit more. Thanks for keeping me company, by the way. I mean, I wasn't sure if this stuff is going to be interesting for the people of the, like, in the server. But I wanted to do something. And, well, I draw, so, you know, decided to draw things. Yeah, well, thanks. Glad to hear that you're passionate about the game, and sorry to, you know, maybe not being able to answer all of the questions, since I'm not that developer that knows everything about the game. It's just a small piece of the common work that I did for it, but glad to be of help, you know. By the way, I have a question for you. Since, well, you're an only viewer, I'm gonna ask you. I was hoping for like a larger audience, but anyway, in your opinion, would it be better for the game or worse if there were like if we would include some how would I put it? Like more suggestive pictures to illustrate the scenes of, you know, like closeness with the girls in the game. Like, would it be appropriate in your opinion? Because we had a discussion, and well, obviously you don't see any nudity in the game. But since the game was 18 plus on its release, we had a conversation about it. So what you think? Would it be better or it would be worse? And it would like spoil the tone of the game. Well, yeah, you might be right, because in the end we actually didn't include anything. Well, my logic was, I mean, nothing super creepy or offensive word was to, how do you call it? Well, we didn't want to freak out anyone with the images, but there was conversation about things like if we're showing the pictures of, you know, people drawing blood and there is like violence going on in the game, and there is some pretty illustrative example of you know, like violence applied to people. We had a conversation of like, shouldn't we, you know, like include something more open about this, like erotic images. But in the end, we actually agreed on like, okay, that might be not the case. Yeah, but I think, yeah, in a retrospective, yeah, I think you're right. The focus of the game is probably not on the personal relationship, but on them as well, a little bit, but not completely. So maybe the adding a new level of intimacy between the characters and the player probably won't be necessary. Yeah. Yeah, it does look like an exhibit. I know, but well, yeah. If I call this a pickaxe, it should probably look like a pickaxe. Yeah, that should do it, I think. Where did I learn to draw so well? Thanks. Thanks again, dude. No, I haven't. I attended a few courses. I attended a school for a year, art college, for a year. And before that, mostly by myself. Yeah, my phone's dead. No music. How did I come to work with Sever? I was freelancing and where? We live in the same town. And I stumbled on the advertisement that, well, they're looking for artist to draw stuff for them. And I applied with several other people. Would you the some test illustrations? At that time, it was actually a different style. They were trying out. I don't remember something. Well, something more colorful. But then there was a few iterations of like when they were looking for a specific style for the game. And. Well, we ended up on making a book, so the ink sketches sort of seemed appropriate. That is a stylistic choice, and everyone liked it, and we decided to go with this particular style. Yeah, and well, basically, that's how we got to work for them. Yeah, true. Yeah, once you get the feeling of you know, how the game should look like, it's very difficult to strafe away from it, you know. You got it and you keep doing it the same way, you know. And then it grow on you. Start to like it more and more. By the way, what do you think? What's in your opinion? What's the best outcome? What's your favorite path for Brante? Yeah, crushing the revolt before it began. Nice. Very imperialistic. Yeah, I agree. I agree. Sophia and those guys, yeah, definitely not the way to do things. Man, I was so sad that I was funneled into dealing with her. And then I didn't have the enough parameters to actually get rid of her in the end of the rebellion. Oh man, frustration. The suffering. Huh? Remember the name of the game. The Life and Suffering of Sir Brante. Yeah, it gives you plenty. Yeah, experience. The great thing in life. The more you play, the more you know. That's true. Yeah, I should definitely give it another go for destroying the Sophia and her evil plans. Yeah, man. Definitely. Something worth trying. Yeah, imagine this guy would side with Sophia, actually. Terrible fate. Made him probably very intolerant to people. Yes, probably he would seek vengeance for all misgivings and all the bad treatment. Looks menacing enough. Yeah, there would be a second attempt for the priest run, definitely. I felt like something's missing. Yeah, well, that's life and suffering of Sir Brante. Getting forced to things. Suffering again. Tough. Life in the blessed Arcanian Empire. As we know it. Well, am I done with this guy or not? I think I'm done. Thank you for the viewing. I hope it wasn't. Yeah, well, isn't so blessed. That's true. It's not that blessed, but it's blessed a little bit. They have gods there, you know, real ones. Anyway, thanks for the viewing. Greatly appreciate it. I was hoping it wasn't super boring for you. And congratulations for being the first viewer of my first public stream, by the way. Yeah, true, true. The cruel gods of the Arcanian Empire. Yep. Well, thanks for watching again, and have a good one. And I hope you will enjoy your playthrough. This will be 13th one. And maybe I'll do those kind of streams more often, but maybe not. Not sure yet. Thanks for the viewing. Bye-bye. Yeah, you too. Have a nice day.